those Phillips screws. Try to turn it on and retrieve all the data available. Find and identify the broken chip. Order new part and replace it. Put the phone back together and it would work like a charm.
I wonder what it is. How hot is it? Wow, 135 degrees Celsius? This is a supercapacitor rated for 2.7 volts and it is 400 farads.
Stop yelling at the camera!
You thought the cap was gonna blow? No, 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 this expensive, I careful. Short the super cap. Of course, the resistance of this wire is gonna limit the current through the super cap.
I totally burned my finger.
First, I have to set up a spot for my scope so it doesn't get dirty. Now I disconnect the battery positive to replace it with the capacitor.
Blades are broken. If I break two opposite blades, then it will balance. Wrong too. There you go. Good as new.
Now to improve the airflow, it's better to raise.
Don't put your hand in a running fan.
That blows the fuse, and it can't even protect the circuit here.
Even their data says reverse polarity connection will result in a blown fuse and may cause permanent damage to the inverter. Absolute garbage.
And for that, I made this harness that you can plug to both sides. First, you plug it to the inverter. Anytime you connect a power harness, connect it to your load side first, so you wouldn't short your power supply or shock yourself. Let's very carefully plug it in. Easier if I just disconnect that specific room, which I believe is breaker number 3. Now we can safely plug them in. Apparently it was breaker number 2. You need to know how microwaves work.
There.
Staples. AC line enters from that corner and feeds it. Pieces it upwards of 2000 volts and feeds it to the magnetron, which resonates and outputs high power waves. And those waves shake the polar molecules, generating much heat. And this is a fan.
Hard to arc.
Holy s***. And we put our pot on the oven and set this to high. And it's on. Who turned this on? Now we cook a fresh batch of hot green noodles to perfection.
It's dripping all over the place. Now it's on fire.
Make sure it doesn't burn on the bottom. Add more as needed to your taste. Lots of poisonous gases. I think it's ready to serve.
Now I'll make a bunch of holes in a ping pong ball using my soldering iron. And this is to block the ventilation, as I'll show later.
Wow.
The result was negligible. Yo, yo, yo.
Let's hope I sealed everything well. I'm done, man. My plexiglass just broke in half under the pressure. Measuring the AC voltages at the input and output. So don't do this at home. Now we'll have high voltages. As soon as I turn on this, what the f*** is this? Ow! Don't try this at home. Now as soon as I...
there's something. I think the gap between the wires is a little bit too wide for the 2 kV to jump across. Ow! Let's give it a try. Come on.